Hi and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be unboxing a doodle crate and I'm excited to open it, especially because we kind of match. It's like the same color as my shirt. So I'm excited to open it and see if anything else matches the color of my shirt. I'm just joking. Anyways, if you are new to my channel, I created this channel as a homeschooling resource to do unboxings like we're doing today, to give you curriculum and organizational ideas, and also ways to invite Christ into your homeschool space. So if you're interested in those things, please hit that subscribe button and let's open this crate. So this month, the crate is Make Your Own Poured Paintings. So that sounds really cool. It says learn about color mixing and create unique works of art. So I'm excited to see what this is all about. It's kind of a heavier crate than some of the other ones, so I don't know what's in here. But that's what it looks like on the top. So this is our poured paintings right here that look pretty cool and different colors. This is pink and blue and green and all sorts of things. So it's our paints. That's what's heavy in this crate. So we have a bunch of paints here. So primary colors and white. Again, it said color mixing, so I'm sure we're gonna use these to create, you know, some of these colors we see here. And then there's a bunch of cups. I don't know if these are for mixing or for water, I don't know. And then a paintbrush right here, gloves, so we don't get our hands dirty, even though we still end up getting our hands dirty. This is a cute little measuring spoon. Look at how teeny that is. And then we have some popsicle sticks right here. And then these look like just clear stickers, I guess. They're hard to see, but they're like a square. And I guess this is our color wheel. So this is cool. This could be a fun like expansion of art in your homeschooling space. You know, you'd have to adapt and see when you're teaching art or when you get this crate. You know, it's not like it just comes when you want it to come. And so you might have to just take the time and be like, oh, let's talk about the color wheel because you got this crate this week. So this could be a cool thing to go into. And then, oh, these are like little canvases. They're pretty thick, actually. So like I said, a mini-sized canvas that's a little bit thinner and pretty good quality that they get to do their art on. And then their drop cloth, which is always important. And that's what's in this crate. So I think this is gonna be a lot of fun and I'm excited to see how it goes because I love painting and sewing. Those kind of crafts are some of my favorites. So I'm excited to let my daughter get at this and we will let you know how it goes. A few little issues, but I think we worked through them. So we're gonna show you the crafts and then kind of give a few suggestions, and that we also missed an instruction, so that might also be a problem, but we're gonna show you what we did. So you want to hold this up and tell them what it is?
It's a circle with all the colors you can make.
So it's called a color wheel. Okay, so she got to make the color wheel, so that was really cool. So they just give you the primary colors and white in the crate, and so she put the primary colors and then mixed them, and then she made some tints in the middle by mixing those with white. So I just thought it was a good intro to the color wheel. And then we're gonna hold up her project so you guys can see them. This is the first one we made, and then that's the second one. So this one might look like it has a little bit more texture to it, because when we did this first, we read the instructions, but the first two instructions right here. I just thought it was having you clip the tops and shake them up. I didn't realize it wanted you to add just a little bit of water, and really it's like a teeny, teeny bit of water. So I think that would have really helped, but I also think they don't ask you to put on enough paint. So they say to use that same little scoop and do like four scoops right here and not to add more than that. But I don't think that's enough. So when we first did this one, it didn't cover all of this page. It only covered the middle. And so then after we were done with this one, and this one worked really well because we used a lot more paint, then we mixed up some other colors and kind of filled in the outside of this. And so it worked a lot better. So I would recommend reading the instructions, which I always tell my kids to do, and apparently I didn't do it today. So do that and add just a little bit more water, but then also use a little bit more paint. Something else is try to choose something that, if you're doing both of these, that's this a warmer color and a cooler tone, because I don't think there's enough paint to do both of them warm tone or both cool tones or whatever. The only issue will be is you'll use all the red, probably. Just because the red is involved in a lot of these colors, whether they're warm or cool tones. So just be mindful of that. But there was plenty of paint to do both of these. You just kind of have to be mindful of the colors you're doing. So what do you think was your favorite part?
Getting to choose what I got to do on these.
Oh yeah, so choosing all the colors. And they do give some suggestions right here. They give you some different color options. Well, they talk about analogous, complementary colors, monochromatic, different things here so they can decide what they want to do. Mm-hmm. So what do you think was the hardest part then?
Maybe trying to get the right amounts of paint.
Yeah, so when she first started doing this, she sat there for a long time just tipping it and trying to get the paint to run. And then after a while, it wasn't working very well. So we just kind of sat it in the box to see if it would run anymore, and then she let it be. So that was probably a little bit hard and frustrating, but like I said, this one turned out really well. It's very smooth, and I thought it went a lot better. So it was fun. I really enjoyed it. We haven't done this, and I don't know if we're going to, but it gives an idea for how to hang it up over here. Like, you can glue paper clips on the back and then run string through it, and you could hang them up if you want them to be an art piece like that in your room. So I thought that was a fun idea that you could do a little bit extra if you wanted to. So we enjoyed this craft. We're looking forward to next month. So if you enjoy seeing these types of videos, please give us a thumbs up, and we will see you next time.
Bye-bye.